maps to twilight. We'll drive it all night, all night long.
To those of you talking, welcome to the show. It's a long show. I can wait.
Fireworks and where you heard and ash where you kept hearts. Sunday made an iron paved in ballads and she fell apart. Who loves you more than I love you, Lark? Who loves you more than the spark? Love's as final love.
Do you feel any different than the kid who first started to play with words and melodies?
That's a fantastic question.
Scatter me out on the prairie. Western gales surpound the gray. Not that this matters, it's not that it's won. A threadbare and battered, and the sun must rise, and the sun must
Do you feel any different than the kid who first started to play with words and melodies?
That's a fantastic question. If you look at most artists that are world recognized, a Picasso or a Matisse, there's a consistent voice that rings through the work. And if you follow the entire arc of their life, you'll see the maturation of their voice and the maturation of their life, but their voice never loses sort of a consistent, I'm thinking of a water drop, a tensile, you know, tension.
Mm-hmm.
There's a tension in a true artist's voice.
Two, three, four.
And so at some point, I realized that what wasn't progressive in my voice was the thing that's hardwired. One of my favorite things to point out is Picasso painted the Madonna 42 times. You know, he came back to the image of the Madonna again and again and again. And at some point I had to allow myself to be repetitive because that was the part of my voice that was seeking clarification.
When did you start assembling these songs in a way that started to take shape into an album?
I took a trip down Route 66 in America from Chicago to Los Angeles about 3 years ago, and that trip was involved in what became the OG Lala album. I took a subsequent trip a couple years ago, which we documented in a series called 30 Days, and that was the trip which these songs started being written on that actual trip. So if you actually watch the series, you can hear me, you know, on the day of coming up with certain songs. And
scream the jets off to Orion, his drone blessed skin, and the hills sing prayers of America. It's hard times we're in. It's hard times. It's hard times. It's hard times. It's hard times.
I was just thinking about Billy and listening to the lyrics of the songs and thinking about different things he likes aesthetically, and I just wanted to create something that reminded me of something he might have on his wall or something he would collect in an antique store.
stuck by poison well. But don't stand still. It's hard, hard time.
Tonight. Flat, yeah.
Yeah.
Is that good?
I think so.
Right. Shoes?
Were you finding that there was an itch in the back of your head that you needed to scratch, something that you felt compelled to say that needed to be said as you with your full name as opposed to Smashing Pumpkins record?
I mean, for years I've said that there, to me there's no difference between Smashing Pumpkins and whatever else I call it.
Tonight. So bright tonight.
I actually only now, just now, feel that it is different. So I have to go back and unwind everything I just said, because I do feel now that there's a different voice that's coming out as a solo acoustic or a solo artist as opposed to the Pumpkins. But I just feel that for the first time.
It's a long way. It's a long way.
I can pick and poke at it, but the consistency of that and the way people have been consistently attracted to that voice, that's the most humbling part of the process.
Soldier of good fortune, obeying that's in right, tidy must, why our nation bids.
So on one hand, I can say, like, wow, I've been given some acumen that's fascinating, because why? Like, what was that? And where did that come from? You know, of course, I would point to the heavens. Other people say, oh, you just got genetically lucky, you know, or whatever. And I don't even care either way, like, however you want to describe it. That's the part I kind of sit back and I don't really understand, because it's like being born with like an inner nuclear dynamo or something that just keeps generating energy and it doesn't stop.
Clementine, the sights you saw.
It hasn't stopped. I mean, I'm 30 plus years. And I think, you know, I have 41 songs coming out in the next year. I mean, that's hardly somebody slowing down.
We're in the middle. We're in the middle, ghosts. We're in the middle. We're in the middle, ghosts.
Sometimes there's something about the incompleteness of the thought that is more commensurate to how you feel than trying to always wrap it up like a movie with a happy ending.
Two steps to twilight.